So Al, we're here at the Aegeus Bowl watching England versus India. It's the first time you've been to the ground, but it's quite a venue, this, isn't it?
Yes, it's fantastic, actually. And with the trees set behind the ground and everything, it's a very sort of mellow place to watch cricket, actually, I think. It's nice to be, I mean, the last game I went to was at Lord's. It's nice to be away from the hustle and bustle of the city.
And obviously, you're a massive cricket fan, so you must love the opportunity to come watch England and interact with TMS as well.
Oh, it's been ridiculous. I mean, I was inside the radio at lunchtime. It was fantastic.
And for you, what's so special about cricket? Why the love for cricket?
Well, I mean, for me, it's Test cricket, really, because it's the unfolding business of the five-day match where you know, fortunes can change and the weather can intervene and all sorts of peculiar, dramatic unfoldings happen. I think, you know, we live in a hurried age, and for something that takes 5 days and makes sure it takes 5 days, I think that's quite special. It's like a slow-cooked lasagna. There's lots of layers, and it takes ages.
Has cricket always been your main sport?
Well, no, actually. I mean, I'm much more of a fan of summer sports than winter sports. But I played a bit at school and wasn't very good and everything, but it's really been in the last sort of 5-6 years, especially with friends who are really into it. You just get infected and rediscover it, and I'll be honest, England doing well in recent years has helped enormously.
Yeah, absolutely. I was going to say, and it's quite a sociable day as well, isn't it? Coming to the cricket, catching up with friends and family, and having a drink or two as well.
Yeah, it's super agreeable. I mean, I also think on some level, there's something good for the soul about sitting in front of a big piece of green in front of you. It's like it feeds something inside you neurologically that says it's all right. Be calm. There's green. Life is bounteous. It's all good. You know, something like that. I don't know.
And as you said, England have enjoyed some good success over the past few years. It's been a difficult last year or so, but have you got some cricketing heroes or favourite players that you've enjoyed watching?
Well, I mean, I have to say, one of the things that's been really frustrating about this last stretch has been seeing Alistair Cook out of form, because he's majestic when he's on it. He's the, you know, I mean, I think you can look to the old days for exciting players, but we live in an era of really exciting England players, and when they're on song, they're wonderful. I mean, when they're not, it's like the bad old days, but you know.
And just going back to the TMS commentary box, that must have been a surreal feeling sitting alongside some of the legends of the game talking about cricket.
It's the strangest thing, you know, Jonathan Agnew's voice and you know, the weird thing was hearing him clearly rather than with long wave or medium wave and all the static and squelch and interference. So actually sit in front of him and hear his voice clearly is a very special thing. I've kind of made it. I should be high-fiving myself, really.
Fantastic. And just the last one, I know you're busy doing lots of various different roles and activity, but what are you up to at the moment currently?
Well, I'm in the sort of run-up to a tour in the autumn. I've got a big tour of the UK in the autumn and the spring, so this is me writing the show. I'm desperate for distractions while I'm meant to be writing a new stand-up show, but that starts in Edinburgh in August and runs over the rest of the year and into the new year, and I'm writing another book as well, so staying busy.